I've been jostling with the deadly, predatory qualities of both sharks and octopus, pitting them against each other in my mind. Now, though, I've been sent extraordinary footage that leaves nothing to the imagination. This footage was shot at an aquarium in Seattle in the Pacific Northwest. Something was killing off their shark, so they staked out the tank with a camera to record any evidence. As a zoologist, my natural reaction to this, other than amazement, is to ask, if an octopus can catch and consume a shark, could a large one take down and devour a person? I've uncovered a report from a man who has no doubt about the answer, based on terrifying personal experience. I've got to find out more. I'm taking a flight to Washington State's Puget Sound to meet a man who had a terrifying encounter with the world's largest known species of octopus. Ron Ault says he's lucky to be alive.
I've been diving Puget Sound since the 80s. I've encountered many different octopus, but the one encounter, the biggest on my mind is, I was working in northern Puget Sound.
Ron was dive fishing for sea cucumbers to sell to the fish market when he came across something far bigger and much more valuable.
So I was on the bottom, picking up the sea cucumbers, and between two large rocks, I see a huge octopus, and I went $5 a pound. So I grabbed the octopus, and immediately it tried to get away. And the next thing I realized, he'd pulled me up about 10 foot off the bottom, but I still had a hold of him. All of a sudden, the octopus' arms went all the way around me, and all I felt was the beak on top of my head. The mass started squeezing over to one side. Every suction cup that I could feel against the suit, my hands, my face, I could not get away. As far as I knew, I could drown right that moment.
Ron continued to fight the octopus as his fishing partners pulled him to the surface by his tether rope.
So once you got to the surface, it took three of you to get it under control.
It really took a long time. Eventually, we got it up on the boat.
You were, with three of you, you were able to get it in the plastic box?
Yes, we threw a lid on it. 50 pounds of weight on top of that. But the octopus actually pushed the lid up. Over the side he went.
I've heard some stories from the Atlantic of people being plucked from the surface, remains not being found. Do you think that could potentially be octopus?
I'm sure.
The more I hear about these giant octopus, the more formidable they are. If they are so stealthy, intelligent, and powerful that they can pluck a shark from the water column and devour it, then what chance has a human being got in an underwater struggle? Unless you're really lucky, like Ron was, there's only one way that's going to end.
The dark, icy waters of Puget Sound are a far cry from the tropical archipelago, but both places are home to a number of octopus species which share the same predatory behavior. For my best chance of an octopus encounter, I'm using a rebreather unit. This circulates and refreshes the air I'm breathing without the release of bubbles, helping me to stalk a giant octopus without being noticed. It's another very challenging dive, and I struggle to adapt to the low light. These dark depths are home to some truly bizarre creatures.
What, Phil? This is not what I was looking for. This is quite a monster in its own right. Amazing what you'll find wedged into the smallest places. What a weird, weird, weird looking thing. So something lives here. Well, look at this. There's scattered shells. What we've got here looks like it is an octopus den. And the thing is not to be deceived by the size of the opening. Well, this is a giant Pacific octopus.
The largest known species of octopus, and certainly the biggest octopus I've ever encountered. It's not showing any signs of aggression, but it is in no way intimidated by our presence or our lights.
It squeezes through these tiny little gaps.
A creature like this would have no difficulty overcoming the rocky passageways beneath Andros.
It seems to disappear and then reappear again. Very impressive animal.
Incredibly, the octopus that seized Ron would have dwarfed this, spanning between 15 and 20 feet.
What an encounter. They grow bigger than this, but this is an impressive animal.
And when it goes from walking to swimming, this shapeshifter does indeed look somewhat shark-like. Is this how the hybrid legend originated?
Looking right into its eyes.
Intelligent, aggressive, opportunistic, and incredibly maneuverable, this secretive giant is a supreme aquatic predator.
Really makes you think, you know, thinking back to the blue hole. What could be lurking in those crevices down there?
If the blue holes of Andros were indeed to harbour a giant octopus, it's easy to understand how it might have remained hidden. And how, in the labyrinths of the human imagination, this extraordinary creature could have inspired the legend of the Lusca.